Welcome to GitKon. My name is Kevin Bost. I'm a senior software architect out of Spokane, Washington with a company called Intellitech. I'm a Microsoft MVP, and more importantly, a GitKraken ambassador. You can find me live streaming and coding a bunch of open source projects on Twitch and YouTube. But today, I'm really excited to be able to talk to you about GitKraken Desktop and how to make you into a power user. Let's check it out. So here we have GitKraken Desktop. I am currently running version 10.4.1 down here. And if you learn nothing else from the rest of this talk, the one thing I want you to take very close note of is this awesome little button right up here. This guy here is the command palette. On Windows, it's Control P. On Mac, it's Command P. For people who are used to Visual Studio Code or similar, this kind of interface will be very familiar to you. Short version, you can open your command palette and you can just start searching for anything that you would like to do. You can scroll through and see that there is a wealth of options available. But one of the coolest is the list of keyboard shortcuts. Now, quite often in applications like this, there's lots of actions you can take. There's plenty of things you can do, but we're developers. We oftentimes like our keyboard and less about the mouse. And so here, being able to actually find the list of all of the keyboard shortcuts that are built into them. One of the key ones that I want to highlight here comes from navigating around the commit graph. So most of the time, you know, we'd like to have a nice, pretty linear thing, but more often than not, we end up with code that looks like this. And if we just use the arrow keys to be able to move up and down, we can see that it just selects the commits linearly in chronological order. But quite often what we actually want to do is navigate per branch. So if you start using shift down, you'll note that it actually is now jumping me between commits that follow the same branch. And the same thing with shift up, is you can actually start jumping between the commits that follow a particular path rather than just going up and down chronologically, which can be really helpful, especially if you've got a little bit of a spaghetti graph and things are going left and right. It's not always obvious which way you're going to go. The other way that you can kind of help clean up this graph a little bit is actually going through and hiding branches. So either in your local or remote, and this will matter here quite a bit, as we start looking at these, note the little icons next to your branch names. If you've got a little computer, PC, or laptop looking thing there, this is one of your local branches, and we can start hiding those things to make the graph get a little bit cleaner. And you can see as we start hiding some of these branches, the labels end up disappearing, and once there's no longer a label pointed to something here, it disappears off our graph. This can be really helpful for being able to narrow down and filter things out. You'll also note that you can actually filter entire folders. Now, Git branches don't really have folders. We just name them with a forward slash, and GitKraken interprets that as a directory hierarchy because that's what makes sense to most developers. But it also means then we have a way of kind of grouping together branches for the purposes of hiding and showing. The other thing that you can end up doing is if there's just a single branch that you are interested in paying attention to, you can actually right click on it and go down until you find the solo option. And this will get you into a situation, whereas hiding a branch gives you exclusionary filters to be able to take branches out of your commit graph, soloing is kind of the inverse. It says only bring the following branches in. And we can start bringing in the ones that we care about so that only those are the ones that show up. And then when we're done, we can go through here and stop siloing. The other thing is, along the top here, we have all of these wonderful tabs that have been showing up with all of our repositories. Now, for the most part, we can kind of treat these tabs the same way you would browser tabs. You can drag them around, you can go left and right. With those keyboard shortcuts, things like Command or Control W will actually close your tab. That's perfect. As somebody who's very familiar with that tabbed browser interface, it kind of works the way that I would expect. The other thing you can do, middle click. Just straight kills it. I oftentimes get a little aggressive and I will just middle clip a whole bunch of tabs until they are all closed and then promptly realize, ah, shoot, I got a little aggressive. I need some of those tabs back. Now, Control Shift T will actually bring those tabs back for you kind of in that reverse order. The other option that you have here is this tabs list. So Control Shift A here. It'll show you not only your open tabs, but also your recently closed tabs. So if you want a clicky way of getting back those tabs that you've missed, you can certainly bring them back that way. The other thing that often happens is the tabs default to your repository name. Most of the time, this is fine, but occasionally you run into a situation where either the name of the repository is big and verbose and you don't actually want that whole long name there, or the name is too short and you've got conflicts and it's kind of hard to keep track of which one's which. To get around that, what you can do is you can right-click on this and give your repository tab an alias. So in this case, if I decide that, you know, this is going to be my infrastructure repo, I don't need a lot of extra detail. I can just type in infra and be able to go through and get an alias set there. Similarly, if I decide, nah, I want the actual ones back into my alias repository and go ahead and hit clear alias there. Easy way in, out, back and forth. One of the other wonderful things that I love to do is, no matter how great GitKraken is, quite often I find myself needing to pop out to either the file explorer or a terminal for my repository. Sometimes you just need to go and run tools there. Now, GitKraken does have their built-in terminal, which is great, but quite often I have extra configurations inside of my own terminal. Now, I'm on Windows, so I am a Windows terminal user. Your mileage may vary, but underneath file here, we'll note that we've got these open in external terminal and open in file manager. So at least on Windows, Alt-T and Alt-O corresponding to each of those. Now, if we go to our preferences, which you can either find under the menu here or this little gear up here that will get you in, underneath the general preferences for it, you'll note I've got this custom terminal command checked. So this is for you Windows users. With it unchecked, you've got some default terminals that you can pick from. But if you are a Windows terminal user and want to see it work, you can actually just do WT for Windows terminal, pass it in a starting directory, and then also %D, as we can see here, is going to end up being the thing that gets replaced with the repository's path. So if you have an alternate terminal, or technically any command that you want to be executed and feed in the path of your repository so that you can quickly jump in and do something, this is a quick and easy way to do it. Obviously, you also have external editors like Visual Studio Code or similar that you can do, but it makes it really nice and easy when you're in something like this, just being able to hit a simple command and then immediately have your pop open your file explorer or drop into a corresponding terminal as well. Now, one of the other things that always gets me really excited, and I'm going to jump over here to this other repository, is I have a branch here. This is my work, where I have done some work, as you can see, clearly very advanced stuff. But I've completed my job. Now it's time to actually go through and open up a pull request. Now, this is just a local only branch. You can see my local main pointer is actually not even in sync with my remote main. But now I need to go through and open the pull request. What I can do is I can just click and drag on the branch that I want to pull request from and drop it on the one that I want to pull request to. So GitKraken immediately gives me a choice here to push my work all the way up and start a pull request to origin main. And it's important that it says origin main here because I dropped it on top of the remote branch, not my local one, which is where we want to go. So it confirms where I want to push and pull from. That sounds great. And then right here, it will open up the create pull request window for me. It's already pre-populated my from and to repositories, which in this case are the same, but it's also set up my branches. If you have things like pull request templates set up, you'll have options as well here. It's worth noting some of the features inside of GitKraken do vary a little bit depending on which provider that you're going with. Today, I'm going to be focused primarily on GitHub since that's where at least a lot of open source and similar work ends up taking place. We can give it some description, reviewers if we need to, picking on whatever I need, bonus points for spelling correctly. As we know, all developers can't spell, or at least I can't. And then we can go ahead and create the pull request. And just like that, I've got a pull request open. Easy button here to be able to jump in straight to that pull request out on GitHub if I want to do so. Otherwise, I can continue on with my work, bounce from wherever else that I would like to go to. On the note of pull requests, we'll note down here, we've got this pull request section available to us where we can kind of get a list of, you know, my pull requests, where we can see my some work is the one here. But we also see this assigned to me, awaiting my review, all pull requests. And we can see down here we've got this ship it option. So one of the nice hidden features that often gets overlooked is you can actually create your own filters here for the pull request. So if we go ahead and click on this, we can see a little bit of documentation. And really these parallel exactly what is possible with the pull request filters out on GitHub directly. So we've got a nice little cheat sheet here, a useful link out to the GitKraken support site for more details, but we can actually go through and build up whatever filters we want. So for example, this ship it filter that I've built, I've said, okay, I'm gonna look for every pull request that has ship it in the body. Not a great filter, but at least it helps me find every pull request with the little GitHub ship it squirrel that's embedded inside of it. More importantly, especially if you get into this issue of assigned to me, awaiting my review, those types of filters, you can go through and customize these to be whatever you need for your filtering. Down here, you can see it, I'm actually getting this awkward little no pull request set up down here. This little guy here is coming from my Launchpad. And if I switch over to here, we can see that I've got a set of issues and pull requests that show up inside of here. Now, Launchpad is kind of your one-stop shop for being able to find all of your issues and pull requests that span multiple repositories. Whereas the repository tab is perfect for being able to see one individual item, it's a lot nicer if you can be able to query everything, because it's quite common to have quite a few repositories, issues, pull requests that span across a lot of them. And I especially don't like it when I have to try to figure out, as my team's opening pull requests in lots of repositories, hey, where the heck is that pull request that they asked me to go review before lunch? I can just come in here, open it up, and quickly be able to find things down. Now, the one thing to be aware of, and you can see it's now found my pull request that has no assigned reviewers, which is why it's popping up here. But rather than just finding the stuff for me, you can actually flip over to this team section, which is currently still in preview, but works really well. My personal favorite is right up here, you get this little filter button where you can actually filter down by user. So I can actually go ahead and say, okay, even though I'm in the team section, I'm gonna go ahead and filter down to just me so that I can be able to find exactly the stuff that I'm looking for. If I need to, I can bounce all the way back out to GitHub and say, hey, here we go. Here's my pull request. Here's what I'm actually looking to do. But I now also get this useful guy down here. And if I want to, I can go ahead and just click on this and then be able to bounce out and find the ones that I'm looking for. The same thing kind of goes for issues as well. We can dive in here, take a look at them. The other really useful part is if this is the starting point for your issues, you can actually just immediately bounce over here to create branch and be able to take a look at the issue, see if there's anything else, and then create branch for issue. It's going to suggest a somewhat useful-ish name based upon the title that's here. We'll say fixing output, because that's a much shorter name. And then more importantly, I can just quickly go through, figure out what my source branch wants to be. In this case, it's very trunk based. So we're just gonna go origin main, create branch. And then immediately I'm back over to my repository tab. I have a new branch checked out, tied all the way up for where I want. Now I can go through and dive in and start working with where I was looking for. One other area that's worth noting, with Launchpad, you saw that I had intentionally gone through and picked out this workspace. So where does the workspace actually come from? It's this little repo management folder icon in the top right-hand corner. So inside of here, what we have is several different types of workspaces. Now, if you are just running on a free tier of GitKraken, you can actually make local workspaces using the GitKraken CLI. And that will give you some benefits in that you can still have the grouped organization for your repositories. But for me, I like the cloud workspaces that'll sync across my various devices because I work on more than one machine. For example, I have my VeloPack workspace here, which is what we were just looking at, where we can see I've got quite a few repositories that I brought in, and I can quickly see which what the state of all of these are. Now, I do have some options here for selecting all and then going through, and if I'm just looking to catch up on where they all are, I can use the fetch all repository button and just quickly fetch all of my repositories. one of the best things ever, there's a change color button. And you can pick any color you want for your workspace. I'm easily entertained. I absolutely love this feature. I'll put it back to yellow because that is the color that it wants to be. But with these workspaces being set up, you are then put in control of where do I want to group things together? What repositories do I want to be able to query across when I'm looking to bring in all of my repositories? It ends up being a much more personalized grouping than what you might otherwise have in, say, GitHub, where everything's just kind of either inside of an org or underneath an individual user. You can then kind of put things together based upon purpose. On my GitHub account, I've got, I think, 160 repositories, and that's way too much for one workspace. I tend to build out separate workspaces for each of those kind of logical groupings of projects, just so that I can keep things organized and be able to bounce in and out depending on where I'm going. With that, I want to thank everyone for coming. Hopefully you enjoy the rest of GitKon. As always, I'll see you next time. Happy coding!